Good morning. Let's do a two-dimensional conservation of momentum problem using air hockey discs. You know, like on an air hockey table?
Flippin' physics.
Billy, please read the problem, and Bobby, please translate.
A 28.8-gram yellow air hockey disc elastically strikes a 26.9-gram stationary red air hockey disc.
The mass of the yellow disc is 28.8 grams, the mass of the red disc is 26.9 grams, and the initial velocity of the red disc is zero.
I still think it'd be confusing if we use Y for yellow and Y for Y direction.
Maybe we should label them disc 1 and disc 2.
Sure, let's make the yellow disc number 1 and the red disc number 2.
But we just did this problem, right?
Oh, we did just do this problem without unit vectors. However, I think it will be useful to do it again with unit vectors. Billy, please keep reading.
If the velocity of the yellow disc before the collision is 33.6 I centimeters per second, and after the collision it is 4.79 I minus 9.57 J centimeters per second, what is the velocity of the red disc after the collision?
Velocity initial of the yellow disc, or disc 1, is 33.6 I centimeters per second. The final velocity of disc 1 after the collision is 4.79 I minus 9.57 J centimeters per second. The final velocity of the red disc, or disc 2, equals question mark.
Bo, how would you like to start the problem?
Well, we know that during the collision in the XY plane, the force disc 1 applies on disc 2 is equal and opposite to the force disc 2 applies on disc 1. In other words, because those are the only forces acting on the two-disc system in the XY plane, all the forces are internal to the two-disc system, and the net force acting on the two discs equals zero. Therefore, because net force equals the derivative of momentum with respect to time, linear momentum is conserved, or the sum of the initial momenta equals the sum of the final momenta. And because momentum equals mass times velocity, the equation for conservation of momentum works out to be mass 1 times velocity 1 initial plus mass 2 times velocity 2 initial equals mass 1 times velocity 1 final plus mass 2 times velocity 2 final, and the initial velocity of disk 2 equals 0.
That was a really long sentence.
Remember, force, momentum, and velocity are all vectors.
Right. We can substitute in numbers and we get 28.8 times 33.6 I equals 28.8 times the quantity 4.79 I minus 9.57 J plus 26.9 times velocity 2 final. And let's see. We multiply numbers together, rearrange the equation to get velocity 2 final on the left side, combine unit vector I terms, divide the whole equation by 26.9, and we get velocity 2 final equals 30.8449 I plus 10.2459 J, or 30.8 I plus 10.2 J centimeters per second with 3 sig figs.
You kind of glossed over some of the math.
I did not say all the numbers, but I explained all the math, and all the numbers are on the screen. So, I think we are okay.
What screen?
Thanks, Bo. I measured the observed value for the final velocity of disk 2 to be 31.2 I plus 7.20 J centimeters per second, which is pretty close to the predicted velocity.
But not quite close enough for dancing.
No dancing.
I agree. Unfortunately, no dancing. I think the air hockey table was probably not quite level, which adversely affected our data. But the main point I want to make is that solving this with unit vectors was much easier than solving this without unit vectors.
Oh, right. Without unit vectors, we had to start by breaking the final velocity of disk 1 into components. Then we had to do conservation of momentum in the x direction, then conservation of momentum in the y direction. Then we had to use the Pythagorean theorem to solve for the magnitude of the final velocity of disk 2, and then use tangent theta to solve for the direction of the final velocity of disk 2. Unit vectors did make this a lot easier.
Yes, they did. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.